Well, LeBron James had 250 pieces in his career at Madison Square Garden. One of those, a 52-point triple-double 2 days after Kobe dropped 61. LeBron currently just 80 points away from catching Kobe on the all-time scoring list. He once again will play at MSG tonight against the Knicks. Let's welcome in Kyle Goon, who covers the Lakers for the Southern California News Group. Anthony Davis, though, played just 23 minutes, took just 7 shots against Boston. It was his first game in almost 2 weeks. Did the Lakers bring him back too soon?
I don't think so. I mean, time, a layoff like that is always going to take time. I mean, guys fall out of conditioning. I mean, it happens so quick. And I think you saw AD being a little labored. I mean, the fact of the matter is it just takes time to get that conditioning back. I think maybe in hindsight, the one thing that they didn't really do is get him a lot of on-court work, but that was just kind of a quirk of the schedule. But he was feeling good enough to go after playing a little bit on Saturday. But, I mean, it always takes time. So I think as AD kind of get some more minutes under his belt tonight. I think they want to play him around 30 minutes tonight. He'll kind of get back in his groove. It's always tough.
Well, that 22-point loss against the Celtics was the second largest margin of defeat for the Lakers this year. LeBron said, quote, "It was an old-fashioned butt-whipping." Have you learned anything from the way this team has responded to losses earlier this season?
Yeah, I mean, one of their goals that they've talked about is not losing 2 games in a row, and they brought it up again on Monday night. It was obviously a really disappointing game. They didn't bring it like they wanted to bring it. They feel like they're more capable defensively than they showed. They think they're a better rebounding team than they showed. I mean, they've got beat in the hustle categories, in the effort categories, and that just hasn't happened much with the Lakers this year. They've had comebacks. They've been down double digits and come back to win close games, and I think they want to show that they don't want to lose 2 games in a row. They've only done it one other time this year, and that they can be a better team on effort.
Yeah, they lost those 4 games around Christmas. What happened with the team at that time period, and why, and how have they bounced back so great since then?
Yeah, I mean, I think part of that was obviously injuries. They had AD out 1 game. They had LeBron 1 game. That was, if you remember, LeBron's groin was not feeling great. He got hit in the groin, and that was slowing him down a little bit. I think they really have found sort of a grind mentality, have started it out 2020 great. They hadn't, I mean, this Boston loss was their first loss of 2020, and I think they had won 9 or 10 games before that. So, I mean, I think the thing that's been surprising, especially different from last year, is that they really bring it every night. The veterans are hungry. I mean, they're not just composed. They want to win. They want to show the effort, and that's why they were so disappointed and want to bring it again tonight.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about AD struggles in his first game back, but LeBron also with just 15 points against Boston. Are you expecting him so close to Kobe, trying to move up that scoring list, playing at Madison Square Garden, coming off that loss, to have some incredible performance?
Absolutely, and I think everyone who is on Twitter knows that today is the anniversary of 81, and it's perhaps a special day. It is a special day in Lakers history. LeBron doesn't really talk about these milestones, but he's definitely mindful of them. He definitely knows how close he is to Kobe, and obviously there's a lot of chatter that some fans won't buy into LeBron until he brings the Lakers franchise a ring, like Kobe did, obviously. So I think he's mindful of that. I think he always loves to show out in Madison Square Garden. Obviously, some of his best games of his career have been here, and I think we could see something special from LeBron tonight.
Well, we all hope so, because that'll be fun and entertaining. Kyle Goon, thanks for stopping by the warm-up. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
Isaiah, speaking of MSG, as a player, when you walk into that building, do you feel an extra sense of, oh, I want to give a performance for people to remember?
I think people always feel that way about, you know, when they play in New York, whether, you know, when it's at Madison Square Garden, because that place is so, you know, revered in terms of great performances and great entertainers wanting to perform and do their best there. And then it's the media capital. So you always want to have your best performances there and basically let it be known that you have arrived. And if you haven't arrived, then you're here.
Madison Square Garden is one of those basically just those iconic venues where people want to play well because of the mystique of the building, for all the stars that are going to be in the front row. The Knicks can be as bad as they want to be, but if you go to Madison Square Garden, it's going to be Spike Lee and Rihanna. Beyonce, Jay-Z. Everybody's going to be there. So it always has that feel like it's a big game, even though the Knicks might not be on top right now. Mm-hmm. But Madison Square Garden, just the building, and like you said, all the great performances that have gone on there, a lot of the great players want to play great on that stage, whether we're talking about LeBron or KD or whoever. Yeah. They want to put on a performance for that New York crowd.
And they have.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they have.
It seemed like for a while the Lakers were cruising, right? I mean, that, like you heard, first loss of this new year coming 3 weeks into the season. But when you have championship aspirations, right, and I believe that was the Lakers' second loss since 2020 started. Anyway, when you have championship aspirations, how important is it that next game after you lose to try to bounce back and give a good effort whether you win or lose?
It's important to bounce back. You never want to lose back-to-back games. But this is the time of year when, from a player's perspective, you know, you have cobwebs in your head. I mean, it's like you don't know what city you're in. You don't know what hotel you're staying at. The concentration level that you need to sustain for two and a half hours every single night, this is the time of year where it starts to slip away from you. But this is the time of year where the good teams in the league, they're able to sustain concentration and they're able to carry it all the way to the All-Star break. And then they're able to bounce back and really, really rev it up again after the All-Star break. But right now, during this period of time, you're going to see a lot of upsets. You're going to see a lot of crazy performances because this is the time in the NBA where, you know, just you have no idea where you're at.
When you're a championship-level team, you hit on heads that you don't want to lose two back-to-back. And more importantly, you want to get that mantra out there to all the players that we're building on for something that's big time. We want to make sure that every game we're trying to get a little bit better. It's like a stepping stone. So, of course, yeah, they didn't play their best game. They lost to Boston. But what we don't want to do is have another setback because we have bigger goals than the Knicks and Brooklyn, the two teams that the Lakers are going to play next. Our goals are to be the NBA champions. And that means we have to do the right things on a consistent basis, understand what we didn't do well in Boston, and make sure that when we go play New York and Madison Square Garden, that we learn from that. And so that's the biggest thing for me. Championship-level teams say, okay, that wasn't our A game. We can't have our C game two nights in a row. You know, there's going to be some nights where you have your C game, but it can't be two nights in a row because we have bigger aspirations than most other teams in the league.
Yeah, and again, I would not be surprised if the Lakers find themselves in a dogfight tonight because, again, this is the time of year where everybody is just kind of a little foggy upstairs in terms of sustaining and maintaining concentration.
And what's really interesting, you see how good the Lakers are on the road this season, 18-4. But they're 4-3 on the road against Eastern Conference teams. So you got to think, traveling from L.A., coming all the way east and facing these teams, I mean, it'll start to wear on you.
This is the tough time of year. You know, these are the dog days. And concentration from a player standpoint, even a coaching standpoint, I mean, everybody is just a little like, I can't wait until the break comes. And some teams leave early, and hopefully the Lakers mentally haven't left early.
Yeah, we'll see. Well, LeBron James is in the building, ready to play at Madison Square Garden.
Oh, okay.
Is he wearing kind of Knicks colors there? Is that an orange hat?
I don't know. I like that, though.
It's smooth.
Yeah, that's fly right there. He's had a couple of questionable pieces, but that's
all right, Isaiah, what do you think about LeBron's look?
I like it. I can roll with that.
Yeah.
You know.
Certainly looks serious and ready for business. You're watching the warm-up presented by Ford. Fantasy tonight, we bring in Tim Doyle to help us break it down. So let's start with Zion. $4,500 for the number one overall pick. I feel like that's the greatest value you're ever going to see for him.
Well, I think it's a massive gamble as well. And sometimes you do have to bet with your heart, not your head. I'm going to play Zion tonight just because, man, how dominant was he in the preseason? Only playing 27 minutes a game in the preseason. He was giving it a 23 points a game, shooting a crazy high percentage. And like Isaiah Thomas just said, these are the dog days of the season. And he's going up against an old, crusty San Antonio Spurs team. And he's going to be like, let's just say I know some guys that have, you know, their first baby and they can't leave the house and stuff. I don't want to name names, Chris Miles. And then their first night to get out in the streets, you know, they're so excited. That's what Zion's going to be like on a basketball floor, I expect high energy. I expect some explosive plays. And at 4,500, why not, Chris?
Doyle, see, that's why the number one rule is once you have a kid, stay out of the streets, okay? That's what you have to learn first and foremost. James Harden, 1-for-17 from three-point range last time out. Man, he seems like a guy that was so consistent early in the season, now very inconsistent with his shooting. So is he a guy that you stay away from?
You know, he still got 50 fantasy points on FanDuel in that game, but I'm really worried about the Rockets right now as a whole. They've lost four straight. You saw the video of Harden after the game getting shots up. Westbrook is playing tonight, and I always find it more difficult to handicap Harden when Westbrook is on the floor.